Hi, my name is Markus Biel. In this video, I would like to explain to you the difference between identity and equality in Java. Okay, let's start. All objects a program creates while running are stored in the memory of your computer. This memory consists of billions of little cells, where each cell can either store a 1 or a 0, basically. When a Java program is running, it usually creates a large number of different objects in the memory. Depending on the size of an object, it will occupy some of the available space. To be able to locate an object, every object is assigned an address in the memory. To illustrate this, let's say our little blue object lives at the address 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue Northwest, Washington, D.C. Now, when you compare this object with another object, sometimes you want to know, is this the object at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, Northwest, Washington, D.C.? In other words, is this the White House? That is what object identity means. One unique object at one specific address in the memory. To check for object identity, you use the equals operator. To illustrate this, let's do a little coding example. We create a reference variable of type car with name myCar1 and assign it a car object. Now we create a second car reference variable named myCar2 and assign it the value of the reference variable myCar1. This way, both myCar1 and myCar2 reference the same object in memory. And finally, we create a third car reference variable called myCar3 and assign it a new car object. So now we have two blue car objects and three reference variables of type car, referencing those two objects. Now what will happen if we compare the three reference variables with the equals operator? What will myCar1 equals operator myCar1 return? Pause the video and think about it before you continue. Comparing a reference variable with itself will of course return true. Next, we compare myCar1 with myCar2. Pause the video again and think about it. Both reference variables myCar1 and myCar2 reference the same object in the memory, so this will also return true. Finally, we compare myCar1 to myCar3. What will this return? Pause the video and think about it. myCar1 and myCar3 both reference a blue car, but each variable references a different object in memory. Therefore, the equals operator will return false. So object identity will tell us if two reference variables reference the same object in memory, or the same unique house, as in our example. However, in other cases, we just want to know, is this a white house or a blue house? In other words, do we consider this house equal to the other house we are searching for? This is what object equality means. To check for object equality, you use the equals method. To get a deeper understanding, let's go back to our coding example. What will myCar1 equals myCar1 return? Pause the video and think about it. Comparing a reference variable with itself will return true, just as before with the equals operator. Next, we compare myCar1 with myCar2. Pause the video and think about the result. This will also return true, as we're still comparing the same object in memory. Finally, we compare the two blue cars, myCar1 and myCar3. What will this return? Pause the video and think about it once again. Unlike you probably thought, this still returns false, even though we compare two equal blue cars. Why is that? Well, first of all, you have to tell your program that you consider two blue cars as equal. Because it totally depends on what you consider equal or unequal. And you have to express that in code. In short, you do that by overwriting the two methods hashCode and equals. If you don't overwrite these two methods, you get the default behavior, as defined in the class object. The default behavior of hashCode and equals is actually the same as for object identity. This is not because the Java creators thought that would be a good idea, just because they didn't have any other option. When they wrote the class object, our car class didn't exist yet. If you want to know more about hashCode and equals, click on the image to watch my video. Okay, that's it for now. Please give me a thumbs up before you go. Thanks for watching and see you next time.